This is a Tracking the Tropics update with a certified most accurate weather team at First Coast News.
A tropical storm. So it has officially formed in the Caribbean. As you can see there on your screen, the hurricane hunters are out there investigating it. They found a lower pressure. They saw that that center is really starting to close, and we have wind speeds that are high enough for that. So you can see here, winds of 45 miles an hour. It is officially a tropical storm. And we are bringing you this update at 4 o'clock because just a quick friendly reminder, with the time change that we had over the weekend, now we get our advisories an hour earlier. So we get those at 1, 4, 7, and 10 p.m. All right, let's talk about where this storm is going. So it is going to continue to strengthen as it moves to the north and northwest. So it will pass by Jamaica first tonight, and it will bring tropical storm conditions to Jamaica. From there, it will continue to strengthen and be likely a Category 1 hurricane when moving over the Cayman Islands. This is new as of the 4 o'clock advisory. As it approaches Cuba, western Cuba, it will likely strengthen into a Category 2 hurricane. From there, it will move over Cuba and move out into the Gulf of Mexico, and that is where a lot of uncertainty lies. So we will know more after it crosses over Cuba and moves into the Gulf. Right now, the forecast is still for it to weaken into a tropical storm again, so that's good news. Now, models disagree on how fast it will weaken. Will it weaken over the Gulf of Mexico, or will it actually make landfall? How strong will it be when it moves on shore, if it moves on shore at all? And where will it move on shore? You can see how wide that cone is, and that's because of all the uncertainty between models. So let's just start with what we do know. We have tropical alerts up, and new as of 4 o'clock, we now have tropical storm watches in effect for portions of the Keys, the Florida Keys. So that is a tropical storm warning for Jamaica, where those tropical storm conditions are expected tonight, and then a hurricane warning in effect for the Cayman Islands, and then it's a hurricane watch for Cuba because it's a little far out still for it to actually become a warning. It will be moving over Cuba on Wednesday, so that will be upgraded to a hurricane warning. And then still, there could be some impacts reaching towards the Keys, even though it will pass to the west of the Florida Keys, places like Key West, under that tropical storm watch, because there could be some conditions, some of those bands reaching portions of the Keys. Here's a look at the spaghetti models. And again, there's great agreement on it heading to Cuba, and from there, they diverge. You have the European model trying to take it west towards places like Brownsville, Corpus Christi, and then you have other models saying it's a northern Gulf Coast landfall, and a lot of them are saying that, but still disagreeing on exactly where it will make landfall along the northern Gulf Coast. So if you have friends, family, loved ones anywhere from, say, Destin, really all the way over to Corpus Christi, but especially over towards New Orleans or Lake Charles, make sure that they are watching this closely, because again, we still don't know where exactly it will make landfall and how strong it will be, but signs have showed that it will be weakening as it does move towards land, so we hope that that continues. Again, just a look at the names. Rafael is the name of this tropical storm now. It has officially formed. Next name on the list will be Sarah. So the tropics are active because we do have this tropical storm now, and we also have an area of development, possible development. It's a low chance, so that would be behind Rafael. So we'll continue to watch that area, but again, right now, just a low chance of any development there. So here's a look at the cone again. Again, it is now a tropical storm, sustained winds of 45 miles an hour. It is moving to the north at 9 miles an hour, pressure at 997. So it is continuing to drop. It is continuing to strengthen. And so we do expect it to become a hurricane before reaching the Cayman Islands and then Cuba as a Cat 2. So what about us locally here in the Jacksonville market, the First Coast? Well, we are expecting to get some rain out of the system, even though the center of the storm, it does not look like it will move over us. It looks like it will stay in the Gulf and way to the west of us. It will likely bring a surge of moisture our way. But some changes. So before we were concerned about a lot of rainfall, heavy rainfall, and the risk of flooding. It does look like the heaviest rain is actually going to fall to the west of us. So we are still going to get rain. And you can see here 60 to 70% Wednesday and Thursday. It's likely more of a nuisance rainfall though, where we are going to be dealing with those showers and downpours throughout the day. But again, the heaviest rain and the most amount of rain expected to fall to our west. You can see that here. So our rainfall totals, maybe about an inch total over the next 5 days, locally higher amounts. Still, the Weather Prediction Center has highlighted our area under a marginal risk of excessive rainfall. So what that means is that there is a low risk of localized flooding. So that's where we get the heavier rain, because it's tropical rain, it's tropical moisture that could create some localized flooding, but that risk overall is low. All right, I have gotten some questions about this storm and the fact that it's November. People are saying, isn't it a little late in the season for this? November is still hurricane season, and this is why. You're looking at a map that shows you every tropical system we have had in the month of November since 1861. Now, what is a bit more rare is a landfalling hurricane. Now, we have had tropical depressions and tropical storms. Hurricanes are a bit more rare. There have been three in history in Florida. So landfalling hurricanes in Florida, with the most recent of those being Hurricane Nicole, which we all remember. But besides that, again, usually it's more tropical storms or tropical depressions. And again, the forecast right now does call for it weakening into a tropical storm before landfall. So we hope that forecast holds. We will be watching it very closely for you. But again, just a reminder that hurricane season goes all the way until the end of November. And it's not unheard of, by the way, to have a storm or two in December or January. We've seen that in history. But again, just bringing you the 4 o'clock update. We now have Tropical Storm Rafael. It is a tropical storm with sustained winds of 45 miles an hour. We're going to get our next immediate update at 7 p.m. and then our next full update at 10 o'clock. So we will, of course, be updating you in the newscast and online on firstcoastnews.com. But before I go, I just want to give you one last look at this cone, because it has changed now as of the 4 o'clock advisory. It is expected to impact Jamaica tonight with tropical storm force conditions, quickly strengthen towards hurricane status, move over the Cayman Islands as a Category 1 hurricane, continue to strengthen into a Category 2 hurricane before making landfall in Cuba, and from there it will head into the Gulf of Mexico, and there's uncertainty, so we please ask that you check back in for updates on that, especially if you or you have any loved ones that live along the northern Gulf Coast. This is what we will have to watch in the coming days. It's not expected to move into the Gulf of Mexico until Thursday, so we have a few more days to figure it out, but we'll keep you updated here at First Coast News. Thanks for tuning in.